Hey everyone, welcome to our new video, and this video is about the differences between CAN repeaters and CAN bridges. A Wi-Fi repeater increases the range of your Wi-Fi, so surely a CAN repeater extends the range of a CAN network, right? No, it's wrong. In fact, this is one of the biggest misconceptions when designing CAN networks. So, what are repeaters and bridges? What are they used for? Where should they be used? And what advantages do they offer over one another? Let's get started. First, a little bit of flag waving from us. Ixxat by HMS Networks actually invented CAN repeaters. It's interesting to know, right? Historically, the main problem was signal reflection within the CAN bus when connecting CAN segments. In response to this, Ixxat developed a powerful internal logic solution, which actually prevents this signal reflection. It has since become standard in today's CAN repeaters. CAN repeaters just forward the signal on the bus one-to-one. There's no CAN controller inside to read and analyze the message, just transceivers. So, a CAN repeater refreshes the signal levels to both improve the system reliability and increase the maximum number of nodes. It also lets you use large drop lines or set up tree or star topologies. However, the bus segments on both sides of the repeater must be terminated at both ends. In general, repeaters can reduce costs due to simpler cable routing, while ensuring more robust and reliable networks. This is certainly a big advantage, but what about the disadvantages? A repeater cannot increase the maximum bus length. It even decreases it by about 35 meters to its own signal propagation time of around 200 nanoseconds. Since the repeater just forwards the signal on the same bus, it's transparent to the CAN arbitration process. During the arbitration, it's required to have the same signal on the entire bus for a defined bit time. So the natural signal propagation time on the bus causes the maximum bus length to decrease at higher bit rates. So let's summarize for you. A repeater refreshes the signal and increases the system's robustness. It lets you use drop lines and allows you to set up tree or star topologies, giving you more flexibility in system design. No configuration is required. They're just plug and play. This saves costs and time. It adds a bit of signal delay, which can affect real-time behavior, but only in a minimal way. And finally, and this is really important, unlike your Wi-Fi repeater at home, CAN repeaters do not extend the length of the network bus. Let's take a look at CAN bridges now. We have one here. And see what the differences are compared to repeater. A CAN bridge is an intelligent device with transceivers, CAN controllers, and a microcontroller inside. At the bus, it acts as every other node, using the CAN bridge to segment a CAN system, for example, to make a drop line or a tree structure. The various segments are independent from a signal point of view. You can decide what message should be transmitted from one segment to another, and you can also manipulate messages or interconnect networks with different baud rates or higher layer protocols. This gives greater flexibility for network design, as you can combine different protocols such as CAN, CAN-FD or CAN-Open, along with different transmission speeds on the network at low bus load. CAN bridges need to be configured, and this can be simple. When forwarding one-to-one messages to the other segment and vice versa, or complex when translating messages or mapping information into another message. This configuration is often performed using configuration tools such as Ixxat's CAN Gateway Configurator or Ixxat's Advanced Configuration Tool, ACT Lite. I will make you another video on this to show you how easy this is to use. If you subscribe to our channel, you see what's new. You see all the videos. So once again, let's summarize for you. A bridge is an intelligent device that acts at the bus like a normal CAN node. It allows you to easily extend the system since the segments are independent, signal-wise. It enables message filtering, data manipulation and data mapping to reduce bus load. It can interlink different network protocols in a CAN network. It adds a larger transmission delay between the segments, 15 to 25 microseconds, and affects the real-time behavior in a larger way compared to a CAN repeater. And it must be configured before using it. Okay. Besides network segmentation and signal improvement, both CAN repeaters and bridges are often equipped with galvanically isolated interfaces. This galvanic separation of devices and network segments helps to improve system robustness and communication reliability. I will explain the advantages of galvanic isolation in much more detail in another video for you. You can find the link below. As always, if you like this video, please leave us a like. If you want, you can comment and please follow our channel for more videos about this topic. See you soon. Bye bye.